In this video, you will learn the different types of images widgets in TouchGFX, their use cases, and how to add images into your UI. Hello, and welcome to this TouchGFX video. My name is Gustavo Sosa, and I'm a field applications engineer based in Mexico City. In almost all UIs, images are needed. Depending on the use case, TouchGFX have different images widgets. In this video, we are going to learn how to add images into TouchGFX so can be used in the UI, about regular image, scalable image, animated image, tiled image, texture mapper, SVG image, and finally, how to change images at UI runtime. Adding the images to the user interface project. So that we can use and add images in the user interface, we first need to add the images files into the TouchGFX Designer User Interface project. TouchGFX only supports images files in PNG and SVG format. When code is generated by TouchGFX Designer, PNG images will be converted to a C++ array and will integrate them into the project's code. Adding the images files into the TouchGFX Designer project, we can do it via three ways. Through images in the navigation bar located at the left, through the images widgets properties, and finally, by copying them to the project images folder. To add images by the navigation bar, click on images in the navigation bar. Then click at the plus sign at the center of the screen or at the plus sign at the upper right corner of the screen. In the pop-up window, navigate where the images files are. It's possible to select all and add all at once. Adding the images by copying them to the project images folder, just need to copy them. Images folder is located at project, TouchGFX, assets, images. Adding the images through the images widget properties will be shown later at the images widget section. The image widget is used to add any image into the user interface. To add an image in the canvas view, go to Images in the menu in the Widgets bar and select Image. Image widget is added to the screen. To add a desired image, go to the Image properties at the right of the canvas. Click at the image. Image asset window will show. You can select an image already added to the project or from the TouchGFX image stock. TouchGFX images stock can be used freely and without royalties when using TouchGFX. In the TouchGFX images stock, we have images for backgrounds, icons, and this can be used with different widgets like buttons, bar, clocks, etc. Add themes options too. If hadn't added any image to the project, from here can be added. Just click at the plus sign. In the pop-up window, navigate where images files are. It's possible to select all and add all at once. The Scalable Image widget lets you use any PNG format image and scale it to the needed size in the UI. It is possible to modify and rescale the image at runtime. To add a Scalable Image widget to the UI is similar to adding regular image. Go to the Image menu in the Widgets bar and select Scalable Image. At the Scalable Image properties, select the image and the interpolation rendering algorithm. The size of the image will be adjusted in the canvas by dragging the perimeter of the image. In the scale and zoom example, it is demonstrated how to scale an image at runtime. A scalable image widget is powerful as let it scale an image to the desired size and can be resized at runtime. Consider that the image quality could be affected. An important point to consider is that the image is stored in the asset's memory as its original size, and the scaling is done at real time so the UI performance is affected. Adding tiled image widget to the UI is similar to adding other images widgets. Go to the Images menu in the Widgets bar and select Tiled Image. Tiled Image widget will repeat the same image in the Designed widget area. This could be useful for backgrounds, for example. In the asset, it is stored the smaller image, but will be drawn as a bigger one, repeated the image in the whole tiled image widget area. In the canvas, expand that widget to the desired size. For example, could be all the area and use it as a background. Animated image widget gives motion to a group of images to give the effect of an animation. It is an easy way of adding animation to the UI. It's needed to have a group of images with a small change between them. They need to be named numerically sequentially, image name and a number, starting from one to the last one. In the animated image widget properties, will be specified the first image, the last image, and the time between them. All the PNG images to generate the animated image need to be in the TouchGFX project. The animated image widget is demonstrated in the animated image example. This example can be used as reference. Texture mapper widget is a powerful widget. It will let us rotate and scale an image. With a texture mapper widget, it's possible to modify how the image is displayed in the UI. As in the scale image widget, the visual quality of the image at the UI will depend on the original size of the image, the final image configuration, and the rendering algorithm. Here we have also the nearest neighbor and bilinear interpolation rendering algorithms. Related to the image center, we can adjust the image in the three axes, X, Y, and Z. Besides this, it's possible to scale or resize the image. If needed, it's possible to change the rotation center. At runtime, we can modify the image in its three axis viewing angles and by this rotate the image. On top of this, it's possible to scale the image too. The texture mapper widget is demonstrated in the animated texture mapper example and in the texture mapper example. You can use these examples as reference. SVG images are images represented by vectors. Because they are represented by vectors, normally, the size is smaller compared to another image format. SVG images have the advantage that can be freely scaled and rotated without losing quality. SVG image widget is capable of drawing an SVG image file. It can be freely scaled and rotated around an adjustable rotation center without losing any quality. SVG images have the drawback that they need to be computed at runtime. Because of this, it is necessary to carefully think in which UIs can be used, as UI performance could be affected because of computation time. To overcome this, TouchGFX and ST have a solution. In some SM32s, like the SM32 U5G9 or the SM32 H7R or H7S, we have a graphics accelerator with SVG accelerator. TouchGFX takes advantage of this accelerator using it in the STM32s having it. For the STM32s where isn't present the ESVG accelerator, need to be careful and consider the computation time. In the SVG image widget properties, it's possible to set the size or scale, the rotation angle, and the rotation center. Here, I'm modifying the rotation angle, the rotation center to the center of the widget, and the scale. In the canvas, it's possible to adjust the size too, and will be reflected in the properties. With SVG images widget, SVG images can be modified at runtime. This is demonstrated in the SVG image example. This example can be used as reference. In this section, we'll learn the advantages and drawbacks of SVG images widget. Remember, SVG images are computed at runtime and can lower the UI performance. In some UIs, it is needed to change the images defined at the UI creation. Changing images at runtime is easy. The only prerequisites needed are: have all images in a TouchGFX project, images with the same size. To change any image at runtime for another one, depending on the image format, if PNG or SVG, TouchGFX have that functions setBitmap for PNG images or setSVG for SVG images. Set bitmap function could be used with regular images, scalable image, tiled regular, and texture mapper widgets. TouchGFX enumerates all the images when convert them and integrate them into the code, one for PNG format images and another for SVG images. Functions setBitmap and setSVG use the images enumerations to display the image. This enumerations array can be found in TouchGFX generated code at bitmap database and SVG database header files. These files are located in a TouchGFX project structure at project generated images include images. To change an image at runtime accordingly to the image format, call function setBitmap or setSVG with the new image number we want to display. In this example, at the screen view, we are changing images every 200 ticks, around 3 seconds. It is set the image number and later is called bitmap with a new image number. Finally, we invalidate so TouchGFX engine acknowledges the change. Now, let's run the example. In this section, we had seen how easy it is to change the images at runtime. The only two requirements are to have images in a project and the images to be of the same resolution. In this video, we have seen how to add images into TouchGFX so can be used in the UI. We have learned too the different image widgets in TouchGFX: regular image, scalable image, animated image, tiled image, texture mapper, SVG image, and finally, how to change images at UI runtime. To keep learning, I invite you to check our documentation, API, and tutorials on our website. You can find the link in the video description. Also, you can check our videos in this playlist. Finally, if you have a specific question, you can ask it at TouchGFX ST forum.